Mike, after two games, defense off to a pretty good start, it looks like.
Yeah, I thought we played really pretty well through probably the first three quarters. Saturday, probably our best, just, you know, overall performance and being able to execute. We still had some things that we didn't play quite right, but overall our aggression, I thought our tackling, our pressures all worked, you know, like we planned them to work. So execution was better overall.
Kenneth Murray was so explosive in the game, maybe his best game since he's been at OU. He was
definitely his best game, and probably just played more under control, I thought. Just, you know, really under control, saw the game the right way, didn't force it, got himself in position to make some big plays. So, yeah, really pleased. I think that's the first game where you could see him really kind of settle in and start to play the way he's capable of playing and kind of let the game come to him and do what you're supposed to do and not force it. And he did that, and he did what he was supposed to do, and the plays were there. He made them. So, yeah, I thought he played well.
Mike, with them having their first game canceled and, you know, kind of having one game against a good opponent without Lazard, is it kind of tough to get a gauge on what, you know, you really face a little bit with this team?
Well, they're going to play well. We're going to need to play a lot better than we did a year ago if we want to win. So it's really not about them as much as it is about us. I didn't think we played particularly well a year ago, and if we want to win, we're going to have to play a whole lot better this year. And that's really what we're concentrating on. We're going to see what they do. They haven't changed much. They're going to run their stuff. The quarterback run game was a big part of it a year ago, and probably be a bigger part, you know, now that, you know, maybe he's down. You know, I doubt it'll be Lanning since he's gone, but yeah, more of the running back doing it. So they did some good things, came in here with a great plan, and I thought they executed very well. They out-executed us for the 60 minutes. So there's a lot of stuff to get prepared for, and they can still be a very explosive offense.
Well, I mean, they may not have Kemp, but, I mean, Nolan's got a lot of tape, too. Does that kind of help you out a little bit, you know, just that you've seen both these guys a lot?
Well, he's, you know, again, he wouldn't be a – they thought he was going to play a year ago when Kemp went in. They thought, you know, we all thought he was the backup, and then Kemp came in and did a great job, never relinquished really his job. And so – obviously, the kid's very capable. He played against Baylor a year ago. So, you know, there's tape. But, yeah, he throws the ball well, and, you know, he's well prepared. He's been in their system. I don't know. I guess it's his third year. So, you know, we expect our backup quarterback to go in and play and be able to execute just like they do.
Mike, through two games, just your thoughts on cover skills in the secondary so far?
Much better. Overall, I think we're – you know, haven't been threatened a whole bunch, but really like our position. I think our coverage has been tighter. I think, you know, overall our pressures have been better, and it kind of works together. So we've been good. So this will be a different test than probably even. You know, we caught UCLA and Florida Atlantic at the right time with breaking in new quarterbacks. So this is, you know, league play, and they understand what we like to do, and we understand what they like to do. So we're going to have to go out and really play well Saturday. But, you know, our guys, I love the way Purnell, I think Trey Norwood, I don't know if he's given up a pass yet. So they've covered well. Buki's played well. Justin Burles has played well. And Khalil, the first group, has played steady. You know, they've done what we've asked them to do, and the coverage has been good.
Do you sense a different vibe with this team or a different mentality? And if so, where does it come from?
Well, I think we have a lot of young energy in the group. everyone's trying to kind of find their way together, and that's good. The stability comes from the defensive line. They don't usually have a whole lot to say. They just go out there and play and, you know, do what they do, just like the offensive line. They play hard, and they've been, you know, really good for us up front. But a lot of the energy has come from that, you know, that secondary group that's young, and they're very energetic and they're very eager. That's the thing I love about those guys. They want to learn. They want to practice. They want to compete. And that's good. So you can tell it's a very vibrant group of players that have worked harder. I think, you know, this is a group that by committee has worked extremely hard through the out of season and through camp. And I think it shows. I think they see what that brings. They're more prepared. They understand what's going on, and they're able to go out and execute better. So I think they put a lot into it, and the results are there. So hopefully they continue to keep working. And we've practiced better than we ever have the whole year out, and that's good. That's a very positive sign. They enjoy it, and they enjoy being coached, and that's good.
Mike, what's the importance of Curtis Bolton meant to your defense?
Well, we've always known Curtis to make a lot of plays. That's one thing Curtis can do. Now the consistency in making a play and giving up a play is not a great trade-off. I think we're seeing a more consistent player down in and down out. And then he's still able to make the plays within the system. You can't go outside the system and try to do things that you're not supposed to do. He'll like to, you know, try to go outside the framework of the defense sometimes and do it his way, but he's become a much more consistent and effective player by doing it, you know, the right way. And I think he's more prepared. He understands his place a lot better than he ever has.
Mike, Mark Jackson was a guy who changed his commitment to you guys in high school. What was it about him that you saw that made him worth pursuing further at once he'd already been committed?
Well, Mark was always the thing you notice about Mark, he was a really promising pass rusher when he was at Cibolo Steel, and he, you know, a very athletic guy that can come off the edge. So that's the one thing you noticed about him when he was young.
What's it been like to see his emergence now after a couple of years kind of coming out of nowhere like he has?
Oh, it's not overly surprising to me. I think he just turned 20, which is interesting. He came here his whole first year. He was only 17. So he's a young, developing player. We keep pushing him, you know, to get bigger and stronger and continue to do more things. And he's, you know, he's progressing.